About the business now is awakening. As you watch the stars, you will see, and if some of you are very much into celestial mechanics, into astrology or astronomy, you will find that the constellations are not in the proximity that they were even back in 1975. They have been displaced. You will find that due to what is called the progression of the equinoxes, even the signs by which you think you were born under no longer are the signs that rule you. They are not your natal ruling signs because they have now changed 30 degrees. Time and frequencies are speeding up. Some of you should have noticed that the days are flying by. The time seems to just slip by. That's for you who are matching vibrations. You become quickened, sometimes agitated, sometimes searching for what you don't even know you're searching for, but you know something is changing, while other soulless creatures say time is still the same. It is not the same. Time is frequencying upward. It's speeding up. You must also speed up, and to do so, you must awaken those glands that can cause your body to keep up with your soul. And it means you will be mutating. Don't become frightened of mutation. Sometimes if everybody mutates, nobody notices. The first mutation will be of the soul progression, and your neuron centers will begin to clean up their act. That's why head colds will be the rule. That's why asthma will be the rule. Asthmatic conditions will be the rule as you try to clean off the mucus and burn it up. The more you use your brain, the faster it will be burned up, and the more you get the headaches, and the headaches will go away because you'll finally begin to frequency like you're supposed to. For those who can't, they will get sick of head diseases and die. For those who can't and are in the body, they'll get attacked by body diseases and die. Dis-ease only means one thing, imbalance, out of order. To hold a charge and not be able to use that charge will cause that charge to burn up the wires, to burn up the connections. This is why you're moved now to do things probably you hadn't wanted to do before. Certain health foods, certain health drinks, herbals. You all wanted to go into the marijuana and stuff before because you know there was something that you could activate. And so rather than do it the hard way, you say, I'm going to just trip out real quick. Not understanding that in a lowered frequency when you do that, you run into lower vibrations, which also are called to a planet with that, and into all kind of trouble, losing your mortal souls. We've all talked about that, but we didn't understand what we were saying. But to a clear head, who through the use of consciousness-raising drugs, now, I'm not talking about now the street drugs. I'm not talking about barbiturals and influenza and all this kind of thing. I'm talking about the wuxis and the fotis and the ginsengs and the things that can tremendously raise your vibrational rate. The pineal gland then begins to activate and not die up and dry up. It activates. One of the reasons why prostate trouble is on the increase in most males is because the prostate gland, which was simply part of the almost dried up womb of the ancient woman part of man, must reflect from the pineal and the orchid gland to come into full bloom to produce the kind of seed that can bring forth the gods. And this is why I'm going to call in the children lecture at the end of this one tonight. We always think of children as only coming through a woman. The seed of man activates the woman, and therefore that seed must be strong to call forth the right kind of soul at this time. As this prostate gland dries up because it cannot get reflected energy from the orchid gland, how many even know, and I don't say it unless you do, because I might call in and ask you where it is, where the orchid gland is. If someone does, please share it. Do you know where the orchid gland actually is? How many have even heard of the orchid gland as being part of the male glandular system? And they don't want you to know. That is like a little sun right near the prostate. It reflects energy from the pineal gland by way of the spinal cord and then flashes. And as it flashes, it increases the seminal fluid energy, which then can house a new type of a sperm cell, which then, when that sperm cell is released or when it is built up, activates the higher glands of man. But it must reflect the light from the pineal. In most cases, the pineal was already atrophied or on its way out. For a soulless mankind, it profits now the knell of the death bell. For it means that if our planet can take in new energy. And if the electromagnetic field or frequency barrier can be altered so that higher frequencies can come in and that pineal gland kicks in, then you will be once again in tune with your planet. And mankind, having no soul, having only the ability to report to the Lord God Master, will go crazy and begin to dysfunction and do crazy things. Human, who is part of both, will begin to question and try to follow its higher source, and the whole thing will lead to tremendous wars or tremendous conflagrations. The war will last no time if the sons of God can awaken to who they are. Because once they get in tune with the planetary head, the planet will do whatever they as a unit ask for. That is what some of the Yoruba people understood, what the magicians understand, and in a small way try once more to get in frequency with the slower heavens just above where they live or on their continent, or the elemental kingdom can obey. It was meant that the sons of God, being of the seed of angels, didn't have to even do that. They could summon, they could call forth, they could put aside. But before any of that could be done, they had to first come into the consciousness and frequency of who they were. Again, I kind of repeat what I said when I was here before. This summer, you will hear, and starting this summer, probably for the next 3 years, about the sunspot activity being on the increase. You'll begin to hear more again about solar activity, prominences, all types of energy from the sun that will be very harmful. You'll hear about ultraviolet light, burning tissue, and melanomas and carcinomas affecting the blood and the skin of people on earth. For the sons of God who have an active pineal, that will be a day of blessing, for it will not affect you. You will not be burned, you will simply darken, and the melanin growing, it's almost like a vicious cycle to make you more and more powerful. As they get cancers of the skin and glands, you will get glands beginning to awaken and throwing out the frequencies that are not good and reconnecting the DNA molecules that were separated. For at one time we had 12 strands of DNA, now we have 2. How could we function as an advanced God or being when we don't even have the right hookup? We can't go to 220. We've got to stay at 110, 120. That will activate the glands to begin to work on the molecules of the cells, and the cells' DNA will begin to unite. What they call junk DNA is not junk DNA. It is where it all got blasted apart, and now, like an amoeba, it will be coming together again, and each cell in your body blueprint will begin to vibrate faster as you become once what you were, the true sons of the gods. For man to be man at this time, man must understand his feminine counterpart that is within him, his animal counterpart that is within him, the angel and God counterpart that is within him, and his own soul blueprint, which is him. That's why you will find people undergoing hypnosis, past life recall, flashbacks of things and intuitively that they didn't know happened, but they'll begin to see their past lives come forth. People that they meet that they'll be drawn to and they don't know why. Places that they'll go and they'll go to and they don't know why. But each time you'll find that there's a benefit that comes when you follow that mind, because it will be something of an experience that will help to reawaken you. You must remember who you were. You must work with the DNAs in order for the DNAs to begin to entwine together. We speak of the tetratomation, which of course Jewish people cannot affirm. They will not say the name Yahweh. They will not say Yahweh. They will not say any of those things because they were not the chosen for this energy. They were usurpers and interpreters of the books of magic without the soul to contend with them. But the soulless ones and the soul ones were both asleep. Now when we understand that